just in time for the new year, California rolled out, get this, 725 new laws for 2011. Before we get to our favorite, joining us now from Florida is radio host Mike Papantonio. Okay, hang in there, Mike. Okay, here we go. First one, AB 97 bans the use of trans fat in food facilities. SB 1317 allows the state to get to slap parents with a $2,000 fine if their K-8 child misses more than 10% of the school year without a valid excuse. It also allows the state to punish parents with up to a year in prison for the misdemeanor. And then there's this one. SB 1449 makes the possession of up to 1 ounce of pot an infraction with a penalty of a $100 fine. RDIL, I'm going to go right to you, my attorney friend. What's going on in California where you can fine a parent $2,000 if their kid's late for school, but catch them with pot, $100.
Yeah, I don't know how they're going to get around people who homeschool. I guess that would be considered a valid excuse. The mere number, 725 new laws, is unbelievable. It's daunting, quite frankly, for people like Bo and I who have to stay on top of all of these things. It just shows you that the legislature, they need to find something to do. This is how they go back to their home district and pound their chest.
Am I expected to know all 725 new laws?
Well, as everybody knows, ignorance of the law is not an excuse.
Exactly.
So therefore, if for whatever reason you decide you're going to keep your kid out every Friday to watch Follow the Money, and he's not going to go to school, but you think it's an educational thing, you miss 10%, you get this fine. You go, well,
and
I know about the fine.
I think you get up to a year in prison. Go ahead,
it's
Bo.
Ridiculous.
Yeah. I mean,
700 new laws. They can't even effectively keep the laws that are on the books.
I was going to say, I don't think we have 725 laws in New York.
The trans fat thing, I kind of agree. Let's face it, that's garbage.
But a law is a law.
We did it in New York City.
Where's my lefty? Where's Papantonio? What about it? What's with the left coast of California and laws and regulations? Oh, my gosh.
It's the dumbing down of legislation. It's no different than any other part of American culture. The legislators we see right now, it all flows from the top. Look, if you take a look at this, any lawyer is going to tell you, probably if you went through law by law and you analyze this constitutionality of each one, probably one third at best would even be constitutional. But the point is this, it's great anecdotal information. It gets the rank and file upset.
Anecdotal? My kid's late for school, I can go to jail?
Because you know what, Eric? Comes right down to it. By the time all these laws make it through the system, probably one third at best are even going to have a chance of being held at constitutional. But here's the issue. Eric, what happens is you have a legislator that wants to impress his constituents,
exactly.
Or her constituent. So she comes forward.
These are laws that are going into effect. This isn't a discussion about the law. These are things that are going to
I'm an attorney also. I used to have to review laws like this. And I can tell you, if in a perfect world, one third of them are going to be accurate. And you know what? The legislator is going to be able to go to his Dimwit constituent. Dimwit legislator talks to Dimwit constituents and says, look, I got this passed for you.
You just legalized marijuana. These kids now know that they have a fine.
You know what?
They'll be smoking marijuana all over California.
Look at the vote in California. In California, the whole legalization of marijuana.
Yeah, but it's a big difference
passed.
When you say
it's
you're
going
only going to get a little
time.
Fine.
The moral majority, when that legislator said, let's come up with this idea, they clapped, they sent him money, he's their guy. It's all nothing but a show.
Hey,
the truth is, if
I'm on a cell phone in New York City and I get pulled over, so the cop sees me, it's $200. In L.A., if I got under an ounce of pot, $100. Oh, hold on, Artie, but let's talk about some of the other laws. Not very business friendly. Look at this food chain law. You have to, you can't use trans fats. You have to put calories on it. They're making it a very business unfriendly place.
Look at New York. I mean, Bloomberg, that's really what he's done. I mean, I'd like to go back to the marijuana thing. I mean, just so people understand, an ounce is, New York, the law is if you have like a marijuana cigarette, okay, you're going to get a slap on the wrist. But if you have an ounce, you're criminally prosecuted. An ounce, nowadays, I think an ounce is about
8.4 grams.
Right, and it's worth $500, $600, $700.
Fine. Papantonio, how left can you be? What is it? It's like, I don't know, liberal left la-la land out there.
Well, it's not, Eric, it's not even a matter of left. It's libertarian. You guys want to, it's not a left issue. It's a libertarian issue. This issue you want to talk about marijuana. This whole idea of marijuana, what are we spending? Last number I saw was close to $7 billion a year in the fight against drugs. Now, is that good money? Is that something we ought to be doing? We want to put the whole legalization on the table.
We're going
to leave it there. We have to leave this segment there. We're going to bring all you guys back. But I have a 12-year-old son who I don't want him anywhere near 28.4 grams of pot.